you're talking about the conflicts in the service of the nobles in terms of time.
Yes, sir.
It's come to our own notice and information that you made a statement to that effect, which statement stated clearly that some of those who are fighting, I mean, those who are inciting the populations are residents of the United States of America. Did you have any discussion like on that subject?
We did discuss that, and I will say that, you know, there's violence on both sides. The government has committed summary executions. They are guilty of detaining people and not allowing them access to lawyers, to their families, even to visits from the Red Cross. They have been guilty of burning villages and looting and of general harassment of the population. On the side of the secessionists, the separatists, we've seen horrible beheadings, kidnappings of government officials, and burning of schools. We want to stress that the United States condemns violence on both sides. We condemn violence, and we want to call for people to listen to each other. Right now, in Cameroon, there's a sort of a dialogue of the deaf. People are stating their positions, the government is stating its position, and the separatists and the people of the Northwest and Southwest who don't support the government are stating their positions, but they're not listening to each other. So I asked the president to use his position as leader of the country to try to find another solution that would allow both sides to listen to each other, and really to listen.
What is it to do for fueling the crisis from the U.S.?
Well, I think, you know, people who are fueling the crisis on either side, there's hate speech that's been on both sides. So I would say that we need to put a stop to the hate speech and get on to working together peacefully.